I'm here with Chris Smart, who's the SVP of eMerchant Pay. Chris, how are you doing?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Now, tell me a little bit about the rebranding and the relaunch that you've just been doing.
Okay, eMerchant Pay, we relaunched the website in May this year. So this is a perfect opportunity for it to exhibit the new brand and the new website with the new logos and what have you, and just educate the market and speak to our operators and tell them about what we're trying to deliver.
And what are you trying to deliver?
Well, we've got a strong product suite anyway. We've got our own acquiring license and payment gateways and alternative payment methods and so on. But we also have a strong focus on our payment efficiencies program, really identifying areas for improvement for our operators and really concentrating on performance and payments as well, which we feel is very important.
And what's different about eMerchant Pay from, say, another sort of payment provider?
I think it's that collaborative approach, to be honest, that partnership that we really come into with our operators to really lift the lid, really understand their business and their payment economy and their infrastructure, and again, help them to optimize little areas where we can tweak a little bit, but improve their revenue, improve that customer journey, and just overall provide a better experience.
We're obviously here at IGB in Amsterdam. How's it gone? What's the reaction been?
It's been really good. I've been going to the iGaming Super Show for many years, as it started off as a kind of an affiliate event and has grown into a much more bigger event. And since its merger with EIG, which we've also attended for many years, it was a perfect opportunity, again with the timing of our brand refresh, to come out here, grab a stand, exhibit, meet the friends and operators and prospects, and yeah, just have some good conversations about what customers are looking for, where there are areas of challenges for them, and what we can do to make their life easier, I guess, and again, that concentrating on their end consumer experience.
And what challenges are there in the iGaming industry at the moment for payment solutions?
Well, payments is always challenging because it's always an area of huge importance, because the cost of acquisition for these gaming operators is very large. Competition is incredibly fierce. So it's our job to make sure once a gambling operator has done that important part of getting a consumer to their website, they can navigate their way around, create and register an account, and then making sure we can offer them the payment deposit methods of choice and making sure that we give it the utmost chance of success and approval and conversion.
Brilliant. What have you seen over the past few couple of days in terms of like new trends within iGaming and here today?
It's been very busy, the show, over the last couple of days. It's actually been that busy. I've not attended as many of the exhibitions that I'd like to have, but there's some really good content here. There's some really good, a diverse range of operators here. A little bit more focus on cryptocurrencies than we've obviously had in the years that have gone. But there's a very good mix of operators, suppliers, consumers here, obviously, ultimately as well. But it's been very busy and, yeah, very productive for us.
Now, obviously, you mentioned cryptocurrency as sort of like a payment platform. What's your sort of take on cryptocurrency and its position within the gaming industry?
I just think cryptocurrency is really exciting. I mean, it's obviously here to stay. It's had its challenges with regulation and what have you. But I guess ultimately, as it's more consumer-driven, there'll be a bigger demand for it on new mainstream sites. So it's our job as a payment provider to make sure that as and when these payment methods are required, that we can offer them in the most secure, robust payment vehicle possible to accept these currencies.
Brilliant. And what's been the favourite part of the show so far for you?
As always, just meeting customers. You know, I mean, it's our job. Ultimately, I'm sales-driven. And I enjoy meeting new prospects, existing customers. I've been in the industry for 10 years, so a lot of familiar faces around. And again, it's always exciting to tell them more about our product and where we think we can deliver value, and just building those new relationships.
Chris, thank you very much for chatting to us.
Thank you.